flight test started back in 2006, you know, with AA1, and we've been undertaking, you know, a significant number of flights, over 9,000 in total, and achieved over 65,000 test points, culminating in the final test point being achieved for the programme. I'm also delighted to say that that test point was achieved by Wizzer Wilson, one of our BAE Systems pilots. And it represents, you know, a culmination of a huge amount of effort, you know, on behalf of the broader enterprise to achieve this point. And what makes me particularly proud is that, you know, here at Salisbury, we've had, you know, hundreds of engineers involved in designing and supporting product, including the, you know, the flight test of those associated systems. But we've also had a team, you know, based at Pax River in the US, at peak, around about 40 people, directly supporting the flight test program. So a particular poignant moment for those, you know, in the last few days. They're celebrating, you know, a huge amount of hard work that's gone into the program and culminating in this, you know, huge milestone.
So I got to fly the final flight last week on CF2, and I had no idea that it was going to be me until literally the day prior. I was, of course, delighted, although at the time when we went for the flight, I knew that it could possibly be the last flight, but I didn't know it would for sure be the last flight, because all sorts of things can go wrong between being put on the board to do something and actually executing that test mission. So you really don't know that it's going to be the last flight until you land, and then somebody says, we did collect the data, we did get the information we need, and therefore it was a successful mission. As I got out of the airplane, though, afterwards, the unusual thing was a number of people approached the airplane and shook my hand and sort of said thank you and said a few words. And our chief engineer, Andrew Mack, had the most amazing words for me, which he actually said was, we brought them all back safely. And he was getting at the pilots, the airplanes, and what we've done here over this period of time with this absolutely huge amount of work, this massive accomplishment of completing STD, is we didn't lose a single airplane, we didn't lose a single pilot. And I think the bottom line is that's the message, that's the excitement, that's the accomplishment, and everyone's very proud of that. And it puts a lump in my throat just thinking about the fact that we succeeded in doing that.
I think all of those that have been part of it, it's a profound privilege to be involved in such a program of such scale. And such technical advancements, really. And I'm very proud to have kind of concluded the STD phase with BAE leading the charge on that. As a team, kind of been leading all the Stovall efforts from the get-go, and really with BF1 being the first test aircraft, first true test aircraft out of the factory in Fort Worth. We've been front and centre with that aircraft beginning to end.
Well, the focus of the flight test team, certainly from a BAE Systems perspective, now moves towards the integration trials of F-35 onto the Queen Elizabeth. So the engineers and flight test team we have at PAX now are working almost full time, you know, towards the planning and engagement of what will be, you know, a significant event, you know, at the back end of this year, where we bring together, you know, the B variant aircraft together with the Queen Elizabeth carrier, to prove, you know, the integration of those two really iconic, you know, assets on behalf of the UK. So really looking forward to seeing how that progresses and matures. But that's the next key milestone, certainly for the flight test team for BAE Systems.